to thee, nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee. Though like a wanderer, the sun gone down, darkness be over me, my rest a crown. Yet in my tears I see grief, sure my God, to thee, nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone. Now, today we'll say the Mass of the 30th liturgical year. And this morning we'll remember in our Mass John Fogarty. Now, John's funeral will take place here in the church tomorrow, Wednesday, at 11:30 a.m. So we'll carry John in our hearts to the Mass. Before now we begin to celebrate Mass, we'll just recall to mind all our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord of mercy, Christ of mercy, Lord have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Now we will listen to the scripture readings.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I think that what we suffer in this life can never be compared to the glory as yet unrevealed, which is waiting for us. The whole creation is eagerly waiting for God to reveal his sons. It was not for any fault on our part, on the part of creation, that it was made unable to attain its purpose. It was made so by God. But creation still retains the hope of being freed, like us, from its slavery to decadence, to enjoy the same freedom and glory as the children of God. From the beginning till now, the entire creation, as we know, has been groaning in one great act of giving birth. And not only creation, but all of us who possess the first fruits of the Spirit. We too groan inwardly as we wait for our bodies to be set free. For we must be content to hope that we shall be saved. Our salvation is not in sight. We should not have to be hoping for it, if it were. But as I say, we must hope to be saved, since we are not saved yet. It is something we must wait for with patience. The word of the Lord. What marvels the Lord worked for us. When the Lord delivered Zion from bondage, it seemed like a dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, on our lips there were songs. What marvel the Lord has worked for us. The heathens themselves said, what marvels the Lord worked for them. What marvels the Lord worked for us. Indeed, we were glad. The Lord worked for us. Deliver us, O Lord, from our bondage, as streams in dry land. Those who are sowing in tears will sing when they reap. They go out full of tears, carrying seeds for the sowing. They come back full of song, carrying their sheaves. Please stand to acclaim the gospel. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for revealing the mysteries of the kingdom to mere children.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said, what is the kingdom of God? With what shall I compare it? It is like a mustard seed, which a man took and threw into his garden. It grew and it became a tree, and the birds of the air sheltered in its branches. Another thing he said, what shall I compare the kingdom of God with? It is like the yeast a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour till it was leavened all through. The Gospel of the Lord. And we'll make our prayers, and that reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans is about, you know, the whole thing of the creation, as St. Paul says, groaning until it reaches its fullness. So we will make our prayers that on our life's journey, in its difficulties, we'll know the strength of God with us. Lord, hear us. And Jesus tells the parable of the mustard seed, a small mustard seed. And we'll pray that, like a small mustard seed, we will be discerning of God's deeper and wider purposes in our lives. Lord, hear us. We'll pray for those in our parish who are sick at this time, those who are in hospital, that they'll know God's strength and healing purposes with them. Lord, hear us. And we'll pray for our dead. We'll pray for John Fogarty. John's funeral mass will take place tomorrow at 11 o'clock. We will remember all our deceased relatives and friends. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of humanity. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, to whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy their prayers, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he prayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Dermot, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, chamber of God, St. Joseph, our blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. We'll stand and we'll pray now as our Lord Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." And we'll offer one another now a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs may we one day possess in truth through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now we'll go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.